Gabriel has always been a man of faith.
I thank the Lord all every day, for every day I woke up.
Those conversations are a guiding force in his life, in good times and in bad.
Well, in 2020, my wife passed. I was living with my stepdaughter, her boyfriend, and his father. And unfortunately, we got an eviction notice because the property was sold.
He sat down with us and didn't want to show his face, but told us a little bit about the decision to become homeless. He bounced around living with family members and staying in hotels until money from his part-time retail job got tight.
Unfortunately, I felt I couldn't do that anymore. And it got to the point where I had a choice, my device or my home. My device is my only connection to work, to family, to everybody.
He set up a tent behind his work, but was eventually asked to leave. He dragged this duffel bag around town, walking 20,000 steps a day. His search for peace landed him on this bench in front of Pizza Hut on South Main Street in Kernersville.
And I was sleeping there almost every night.
That's when Heather Bowden noticed Gabriel on her way into Planet Fitness.
I thought about him all day long and about how cold it was going to be. And I prayed about it and I said, I'm going to go. And if he's there, I'm going to see if he'll let me buy him a hotel room for the night, somewhere safe and warm to stay.
Heather and her family put him up for a night at the Sleep Inn. Her husband's coworker, a fellow Kernersville police officer, paid for the second night.
And I used that opportunity just to talk to him and said, what are your immediate needs? Can I go buy you something to eat? Can I get you some clothes? What do you need? He said, I need prayers and good thoughts. Like his exact words, I need prayers and good thoughts.
He didn't ask for anything.
Didn't ask for a thing.
So Heather asked for him, posting this on a Kernersville Facebook page, and the request took off.
Thousands of messages.
More than 300 comments and 200 shares.
A lot of people in the community knew who he is, mm-hmm. from his job in retail, you know, mm-hmm. his spirits, and he's a people person. He loves to talk to people. He's very easy to remember.
Now Gabriel has a place to stay until the end of the year. Clothes and even some of his meals paid for.
We all need that reminder that, you know, that there is good people in the world and that people will help their neighbors and help each other out.
Heather and a handful of others are helping Gabriel by driving him to work and finding the right documents so he can apply for disability and food stamps, giving him a blessing he never expected.
You sound very hopeful for the future, but I think you were hopeful this entire time.
I have been. I just knew the Lord was, I was in a situation, the Lord, and I look at it as the Lord was trying to teach me something. He gave me a different perspective on this world.
What did you learn? What do you think he taught you?
He taught me that don't judge people from the outside. I had learned this before, and I somewhat had forgotten it. But don't judge the person sitting there that looks homeless because you don't know his story, mm-hmm. or her story. Don't judge someone who's looking for help.
A practice in faith we could all learn from this holiday season. In Kernersville, Madison Forsey, Fox 8 News.